Hi, this is Nalene. Today I'm going to show you how to start your course. First thing I'm going to do as a teacher of a course is turn editing on. I'm on Reach to Share Moodle website. So first thing is, as I said, turn editing on at the top right. Okay, next I'm going to give a title to each of these topics. Okay, so that's number two. I click on the topic. Notice the first one is general. You can add your syllabus and about the course there. Okay, so the first topic section edit button is right there. If you put your mouse over it and hover it, click on it, you'll get edit section. So you know you're editing the section. You can also highlight it, hide it, or delete the section, which I don't recommend, but you can always add it back if you did by mistake. So click on edit section. Here you're going to give the name of your section. You can always change these. Notice if you're giving it a custom name, you need to take a look at this button here, radio button, click on it there. And now you're able to add your custom section title. Okay, so let's go back. So you've added all the headings or modules or topics, whatever you want to call them. Four, if you want more, you add plus and you'll have the ability to add another section. You can have as many sections as you want. Next, you're going to start adding content. Of course, this is after you go to the general and you add your syllabus or about the course. So I'm going to add an activity or resource. This is where we want to add content as well as activities. And notice there are lots of activities you can play around with and choose them. There are fewer courses, so I wouldn't start with a book. You need to do that. Label is where you add your headings. And notice each of these have a rich editor. You'll see about that as you go. So if I'm going to add a label, you can also add files, folder, URL, or page. So I'm going to click on label, click on add. You always do the same thing. If you want more information, it's on the right here. And then notice the editor opens up. This is a rich editor. I'm going to make it even larger by clicking on this show, hide, advanced buttons. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows, where before I had only 3. So here I've got more options. Play around, take a look at it. You can also record your voice using audio recorder or video recorder. You can also add your photo straight to the editor. Take a photo from your system. Okay. And notice there's also a record button here and a video recorder here. These are shorter. These are longer. Okay, so once you add, you can also hyperlink. Take a look at this editor. It's quite intuitive. So for the label, I'm going to add whatever you want to add, action, songs, or it's up to you. And then common module settings, don't ignore these. Ignore the restrict because you don't want people to be restricted to get into that section. Complete. You don't want students to be able to do anything for a simple, okay, here it is. I'm going to make it larger, show you how simple heading. A label is just a heading to your section. And you can have various headings as you go. So for example, I'm going to make this small. It's just a bit bigger, but smaller. And then, okay, here we go. There it is. Now I've got action songs and I can add resource and activities. So resources are your content. You can upload a file, you can have a folder with lots of files in it, or you can follow through a book and have it like a book where students can also download the book. Or you can have just a link, it could be a video link or anything you'd like to add. Okay, once I do that, I'm going to have the students interact with the content, and there are various ways of doing that. You can have a form, that's the easiest, where you can ask questions. Students have to response. If you add a form, you can also add a requirement. So I'll just call it a test. Notice the same editor. I've made it larger. You can add anything here, including YouTube videos, if you like, by going into this to add a video of any sort. Click on it and then go into the browse repositories where you can add your YouTube video directly from here. I'll just write test. And then I'll get something up here, but you can add the actual link. Okay, lots of things for test. You can also go to your Google Drive and connect that. Click on it, and then it'll be connected to your account. Okay, you can do that. Or you can simply upload a file. Okay, don't recommend it for videos because they may be too heavy. And if they're too heavy, It's just going to make your course very slow. So I suggest you use YouTube videos. And that's it. That's for now. Let me know if you have any questions and enjoy your course. Teaching online is very rewarding, as you'll soon find out.